Hey guys, what's up? This is Wes from PCJews, and today I'm going to bring you a little build style gameplay, not gameplay, commentary. It's a guide to building a floating fishing trawler. The best things about this is that you can build one pretty much in any ocean, and you'll be safe from almost every mob because Endermen can't walk on water, zombies and skeletons can't spawn on water, and spiders are very slow swimmers. So you only need these items. This is optional. This is also optional, but it really does look nice. This is optional. It's just decor. You'll see what ends up being decor in the end. I'm using too many items, so I spawned all this stuff. You guys, on the other hand, if you're using legit world, can earn it. This is all, you know, if you want this stuff. If you want to grow a cactus farm, it's fine. But the thing is, you're going to want to start off building posts like this up from the bottom of the world to height, like eye height. You'll probably want light stone. You can use a jack-o'-lantern, but you'll want to make it about, I don't know, 10 in each direction. That's not very specific. It's just support beams, quote-unquote. They're actually useless because blocks float in Minecraft, but it makes it look cooler. It makes it look more realistic. Anyways, the light stone, as you'll see, ends up being buoys for fishing, so you can actually see at night instead of having to just throw your line in and just, like, cross your fingers. So they end up being useful. Ah, god dang it. Whatever. I built it one off. It doesn't matter. It's just support. It's just looking like support. It's just aesthetics. It's not even doing anything. Hell, I'm just going to make mine a triangle. But you're going to want this if you want it to look nice. It's optional stuff. The light stone is pretty useful. I would highly recommend the light stone. Even if you don't do this, just go down underground. Just go down underwater, start below your house, and, you know, put some light stone throughout. Okay, so I got the general idea going. Now I'm just going to place some wooden blocks across the top, not passing my posts, as it will look stupid at that point. This way. Again, the advantage of this, no mobs can get you. Let's see, you're out separate, like PvP servers. If you do this out at pretty far coordinates, not many people will bother to swim across an entire ocean, especially not if they don't think that anyone's out there. So you can have you can even do this underwater if you are willing to clear out the water around you, and you'll have an infinite food supply from your fishing line. Let's see. The Enderman thing is great. Yeah, it's a pretty cool design. It's not very hard to make. It doesn't take many items, and it's useful. All right, there we go. So now I'm just gonna start filling the floor in. I'm gonna try to leave a space in the middle for fishing. You guys will end up seeing, but like this. And let's see. The great thing about this is that you can build like a mine shaft going down. I'll actually end up doing that later in the video. Show you guys what to do. Anyways, you won't have fly mod if you're on a server, most likely. So I'll do that part without fly mod. Just show you what the simple little tools of it are. And I'll jump ahead till I finish creating the floor, and I'll get back to you. Okay, so now that I have my floor dug out into a pretty nice shape, I'm gonna place wooden slabs along this middle hole that I left. This is going to be your fishing spot mostly, but you can also use it as your mine if you choose. I, however, always use my fishing spot in the middle. And the thing about half blocks is that when you pull a fish up, sometimes it'll just land in the water and you have to jump down to get it. But half blocks, it can actually jump. The fish can jump from your line onto the half block, and you can land and just walk down and get it here without actually having to get into the water. So it's more useful for the timing purposes, at least. It's more useful. So now that we have the floor finished, I'm going to go on ahead and get started on a tree. I'm just going to actually literally plant fences up. Mind you, you can now jump on fences in place, so that's useful if you don't have fly mod. And I'm going to plant fences up and then just place dirt on top. Actually, no, wait. Torch, then dirt on top of the torch, and then tree. On all sides. Let's see, where's this dirt? Okay. Alright, and you can just do that And you can do that on all four corners. They'll have enough light, they'll be elevated, and this will be actually a pretty good shading thing. Like it'll end up looking nice when it's done. You can use light stone instead of torch. I think that torch gives better tree light, but you know, some people prefer light stone, and that's perfectly fine. Okay, so now that we have that done, I'm going to create a one staircase thing up. I'm going to start at one edge of my house. I won't start here. I'll just place wood, place two woods. And this will just be the staircase up, so you can mine out the trees when they get done. And you'll see that the roof is actually going to be half wood blocks. It looks nicer. You can use real wood, but I personally enjoy the half wood look because I'm a selfish, not selfish, because I'm picky. I'm very aesthetically picky. I'm like a girl. Total 100% girl. Alright, anyways. Okay, so I've got the staircase up, and it's going to be even with the tree. So it's going to be like this. And it's just going to be all the way across. You're going to have to, of course, not plant here. At least only go like one, two. Now I can go four out before I start hitting my head trying to get up. And you're going to have to leave room from there to the other one here. And there you go. So you know you can still get up and down your staircase without actually knocking a block. So you're going to want to leave that open. You're just going to finish creating the roof. I changed my mind about the light stone glass thing. I'm actually going to do light stone across this layer. Dang, nabbit, instant mine. You're so annoying. Arrgh, derp it. No, God, wrong thing. No, God, dang it. Oh, that was complex. Anyways, I'm going to do light stone along this edge, like a trimming of light stone, I guess it would be. The glass is going to be to and from it. I'll show you what it looks like when I get there. So this is what my roof ended up looking like, and I'm going to go ahead and time night it just so you guys will see how it will look at its darkest point. What did I do? One moment. Just going to re-derp you. Okay, there we go. Alright, so this is going to be pretty much the darkest my deck is going to get. Ugh! God dang. Stupid Instamine. Why you gotta make things so difficult and convenient at the same time? Anyways, so as you can tell, it's still pretty bright. It's not gonna let any mobs spawn for sure. There's not much else you can do in the way of customizing your deck. You can do like a boat dock if you get really good. Pistons would work for holding a boat up, and then you drop the piston, it drops into the water. However, it wears and tears on your boats. Anyways. The thing about this is now, if you want to, you can cover it off. You can use glass panes. This is where glass panes and the new fence box come in handy, if you so desire. You can do this. And you can go all the way across the bottom and just have like openings. It's like a beach house-esque feel to it at this point. Plant here, here, and just keep going across. And at some point, you can just stop and place like a view, an ocean view, pretty much. It's just a nice feel to the house. It doesn't actually do anything useful. Just if you are an aesthetic person like me, you may want to do it. Okay, so what I just realized is that I actually like the look of the fence post in the middle more than the glass pane, so I just replaced it. This side, of course, won't work because there's the staircase in the way. But, yeah. So now I'm just going to do other little bit of aesthetic stuff. Of course, with this new update came the ability to make tables like this. You can use this. And chairs now. Well, what seems to look like chairs. they're pretty useful. Aesthetically useless in actual Minecraft. But, god dang it. Okay, and then place sign. And then place a sign. I'm sure all you guys know how to do this, but there you go. And you got yourself a chair. And you can sit down and eat dinner with your friends, like, nom, 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 nom. And you can just, like, ah, God. Just eat it up, and that's fun. You've got your fish to catch, then your place to eat it. And I'm just gonna, just in case you have, like, a girlfriend or a wife or something, just in case you've already ruined your life and gotten a wife. Bam, that rhymes, must be true. You can do two chairs, and it still looks nice. Let me see. Yep, see, trees have grown. Yep, three trees have grown, so you've got wood. You can never say that you don't have wood. And in the daytime, it's still very bright because there's glass letting through light here, and of course, your walls are still open. So it's very useful, and now it's time, since this is going to be your actual house, I'm going to go on ahead and show you guys how to make the mine. I'm going to go on ahead and tell you guys to do ladders. This is a little bit later in the video. It's going to go in the previous section, though. Yeah, go on ahead and get ladders, too. So I'm just going to grab that really quickly. Okay, so you guys are going to have to add one more item to that list. It's just cobblestone, easy to get. It's nothing special. But if you want your mine to, of course, be usable, like able to place things on it instead of just having it there, you're going to want cobblestone. And I'm going to start at one side of my house and just build down like this. And come back up. And get some air. And start over and just keep going my way down like this. At some point, you're going to have to get to the bottom and make a quick torch place, like right here. You can just go, bam, that gives you a quick breath of air, and you got your torch back, so nothing's lost. You can place another, keep doing it. The water will, of course, replace it. I'm going to make this a bit more aesthetically pleasing here. I've got this started picking back up where I started. This is going to be the back wall, so it's going to go up like this. Place a torch for air. Just keep going and going and going, like the Energizer Bunny. And soon enough, we're going to reach the top. Grab some air. And now, this part is actually going to have to be knocked away. I built this too far in. But I'm going to go on ahead and place ladders down now. Alright. And of course, the ladders stop water flow, so you can grab air. And you're inside, and you can just keep going down. You'll want to place a torch somewhere. It doesn't really matter, or lightstone, but if you don't have much lightstone left, I just recommend doing this really quickly. Climbing up your ladder, placing a block all the way up here, and going up on three sides, and you'll be able to. I've got reach on, so I'm saving you some time, some video watching time. You're going to be able to place here and then clear this area out with torches. It'll knock out the water. Mind you, there's like one block left at the top. There it goes. There's all the water. I lied, there's one last block. And now you have a pretty bright, pretty safe way, and you can just go up again, continue doing it. But it's pretty much all the light you'll need. It keeps monsters from spawning, and stuff like that is safe. At some point, you can start spiral staircasing down. I really just like ladders. So to me, it's up to you. I'll show you guys what the spiral staircase change will do right after I place this. No, God, stop, go away. No! Dang it, I'm screwing everything up now. Now, of course, what's great about the tree farm is that it works. So you can actually just go use that for wood to make the ladders, and trapdoors are another optional block. They're just aesthetic, but you can place it on top of your staircase. So only you can get down, and only you can get down when you want to get down, instead of accidentally falling and stuff. Oh, fly is on. Okay, then close you again. Go down, and that's a safe way, and I'm going to go on ahead and get to the bottom, fly, and I'll just show you guys what you can change at any point to the spiral staircase if you so desire. Just, I'm going to knock you and place you there. And you're going to have to 4x4 it, at least. Alright, and you've saved yourself the need from ladders. You've still got a way up and down. And of course, this is a common Minecraft technique. So, after that, you've got your mine, you've got your view, you've got your aesthetics, you've got everything going on. You've got the wood that you need. You can always get to land if you want. You really won't need to unless you want to kill like a sheep and get wool for a bed. But if you're on a server, it doesn't really matter because everyone has to be in a bed and there's always someone who's out. Let's see, you can always build out. You can always attach with platforms to... This is what I'm calling platforms. You can always attach this to another area. Like, I can just jump out here and go I want to build to another room and just da 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 da. You can always build up. You've got a lot of leeway. You've got a lot of room. And it's safe, as I explained earlier. You got your trees and this thing at a distance actually does look really cool. I should probably build one more post, but I'm not going to because I'm lazy. And it's really nice. It's a nice build, easy build. It's not very resource dependent to get, like, normally if you want to build a safe house, you're going to have to, you know, dig around a ton underground. This didn't take much time, like 15 minutes. It took, I don't know, 5 stacks of wood for the labs and this. And then if you got aesthetic with it, it would probably take about 8 stacks of wood. So it's not even that much. And then you're always got the trees up there. And let me show you the demonstration. The fishing rods are... Alright, I bounced it off the wood. It still landed in the water, so it's fine. Got myself a fish. And this is the fishing trawler. Useful design. If you liked it, if you used it, please rate it. Tell me what you think could be improved. If you have any add-ons, like if you figure out, oh, if you use pistons, you can da-da-da-da-da. I'm not good with pistons, but I'll certainly hear you out, and I'll add an update video as this gets bigger and better. If you really liked it, please subscribe. There will be content like this coming out more often, and thank you very much.